To remove the combined front I/O panel and power switch, first remove the access panel and the front bezel. Detach the front I/O and power switch connectors from the motherboard. Free the connectors from the cable guides on the side wall of the PC. Detach the Torx head screw, securing the front I/O and power switch to the front of the unit. Press down on the tab at the top of the power switch. Pull the top and then the bottom of the power switch into and then out of the unit. The combined front I/O and power switch has a tab at the bottom edge that fits over the bottom notch of the cutout for the front I/O on the PC. To reinstall the front I/O panel and power switch, align the bottom tab of the front I/O panel over the notch inside the unit. Then swing and press the top into place until the tab at the top of the power switch snaps into place. Secure the front I/O panel and power switch with its Torx head screw. Secure the connectors for the front I/O and power switch into their cable guides on the side wall of the PC. Reattach the connectors that run from the front I/O panel to the motherboard. To remove an expansion card if present in the unit, first remove the access panel. Remove any external connectors from the expansion card, such as wireless antennas. Detach any internal connectors to other system components. Lift the latch for the expansion card's retaining bracket and swing the bracket out. Press down on the latch for the PCI x16 slot on the motherboard if removing a card from the PCI x16 slot. Carefully pull out the expansion card. To replace an expansion card, carefully align and push the card into its slot on the motherboard until it is fully seated. Make sure any connectors are not pinched under the card. Rotate the expansion card's retaining bracket back into place to secure the card. Attach any internal connectors necessary to other system components. Attach any external connectors if necessary, such as external wireless antennas. To replace system memory, first remove the access panel. Simultaneously push down on the clips on either side of the DDR4 DIMM socket to release the memory module. Carefully pull out the memory module. There is one notch on the bottom of every DDR4 DIMM module, offset from the center, that fits over a tab in the DDR4 DIMM memory socket. When installing DDR4 DIMMs, align the notch on the module with the tab in the socket. Press the module into the socket until the clips on both sides of the socket lock into place. To remove the hard drive, first remove the access panel. Detach the power and data connectors from the rear of the drive. Pull out on the green drive release latch and slide the hard drive out of the drive bay. If replacing a 2.5-inch drive, detach the four Torx 15 screws securing the 2.5-inch drive to the drive tray. Note, you will need a slender-barreled screwdriver to access the screws. Slide the drive out of the tray. If installing a 2.5-inch drive, slide the drive into the tray to engage the drive with the connectors on the tray. Secure the drive to the tray with its 4 Torx 15 screws. Detach the 4 guide screws from the old hard drive, or hard drive tray, 2 on each side, and install them on the sides of the new drive, or drive assembly. Additional guide screws can also be found at the side of the hard drive bay, inside the PC, for an expansion hard drive. Slide the drive, or drive assembly, spindle side up into the drive bay until it snaps into place. Connect the power and data connectors to the hard drive. To replace the system fan, first remove the access panel. Next, detach the fan connector to the motherboard. Remove the 3 Phillips head screws that attach the fan to the rear of the PC. Keep your hand on the fan as you remove the last screw to keep it from falling, then pull the fan out of the PC. There is a hole on the top corner of the system fan that aligns over a small post on the rear of the PC. To replace the system fan, align the fan so that it is blowing outward. The label on the fan should be facing out of the system. Align the hole on the fan over its dimple, and align the screw holes of the fan with the screw holes at the rear of the PC. Secure the fan to the rear of the PC with its 3 Phillips head screws. Reattach the fan connector to the motherboard. To remove the speaker, first, remove the access panel and the front bezel. Detach the speaker connector to the motherboard. Free the connector from the cable guide inside the unit. Remove the Torx head screw on the inside front wall of the PC that secures the speaker to the front of the PC. Slide the speaker down and remove it from the unit. There are 3 guides on the inside front of the PC that the edges of the speaker slide under. To replace the speaker, press the speaker onto the front wall of the PC slightly under its usual position. Slide the speaker over and up until it fits under its guides. Replace the Torx head screw at the bottom corner of the speaker to secure it to the unit. Replace the speaker connector into the cable guide on the wall of the PC. Replace the speaker connector to the motherboard. To remove the SD card reader, if present in the unit, first remove the access panel and the front bezel. Detach the SD card reader connector from the motherboard. Free the connector from the cable guide on the side wall of the PC. Detach the Torx head screw, securing the SD card reader to the front of the unit. Press down on the tab at the top of the reader to release the card reader and pull the reader out from the front of the unit. To replace an SD card reader, feed its connector in through the front chassis cutout for the reader. Slide the reader into the cutout until the top side retaining tab snaps into place. Secure the reader to the front of the unit with its Torx head screw. Route the card reader connector into the cable guide on the side wall of the PC. Reattach the SD card reader connector to the motherboard. CMOS factory settings should be restored as a first step before replacing the system motherboard. To restore CMOS factory settings, first remove the access panel. Remove the battery from the motherboard. Wait 30 seconds. Replace the battery to the motherboard. CMOS factory settings are now reset. Note that you will now need to enter system BIOS and reset the clock in BIOS after this procedure. To remove the power supply, first remove the access panel. Then, detach all power connectors to the motherboard. Note that some of the power connectors have a latch that must be pressed to release the connectors. Free the 4-pin connector near the heatsink from the inside of the heatsink screw post. Some of the connectors are secured in a cable guide on the side wall of the PC next to the motherboard. Free the connectors from the cable guide. Next, detach the 4 Torx head screws that connect the power supply to the PC. Press the latch at the inside edge of the power supply in the unit and slide the power supply into the PC before fully removing it from the unit. Always replace the entire power supply. Never attempt to work within the power supply unit. There are guides inside the PC that indicate the position of the power supply. There is also a latch on the inside of the PC that helps secure the power supply to the PC. To replace the power supply, align the power supply within the guides, then slide it back until it locks into place next to the latch. Reattach the 4 Torx head screws at the rear of the chassis. Secure the front side power connectors into the cable guide near the motherboard. Tuck the 4-pin power supply connector inside the screw post of the heatsink. Reconnect all power connectors to the motherboard. To remove a serial or parallel port adapter, if present in the unit, first remove the access panel. Lift the latch for the expansion card's retaining bracket and swing the bracket out. Detach the connector for the serial or parallel port adapter from the motherboard. Carefully remove the serial or parallel port adapter from the unit. To replace a serial or parallel port adapter, align the back slot edge of the adapter into its position at the rear of the unit. If installing a parallel port adapter, the adapter will hook into part of the PCI x1 slot on the motherboard. Reattach the connector to the motherboard. Rotate the expansion card's retaining bracket into place to secure the adapter. To remove the motherboard, first remove the access panel. Remove any expansion cards or adapter cards. System memory. The heatsink. And the CPU. Partially remove the optical drive to provide access to all motherboard screws. Detach all connectors to the motherboard. Remove the 8 Torx head screws that attach the motherboard to the PC. carefully pull out the motherboard. Place the motherboard in an anti-static bag. There are several clips on the side wall of the PC that help secure the motherboard in place. To replace the motherboard, carefully place the motherboard in the unit, clearing connectors from under the edges of the board and aligning the motherboard inside its clips on the side wall. Replace the 8 Torx head screws to secure the motherboard to the unit. Replace all connectors to the motherboard. Replace the optical drive into position.